Joins us on the line. Good afternoon, Governor.
Good afternoon, Ron.
Governor Garcia, I would like to apologize for the error we made this afternoon. We'd like to assure you that we have corrected that, and that's the reason why we're talking to you right now to clarify that report. You are still at the Capitol, and you have no plans of leaving the Capitol.
Yes, first of all, I'd like to thank ANC for the apology. It was rather a startling report that came out, and what startled me was that nobody called me up to verify on such a report that has an earth-shaking impact on an audience that has been focused on this major story of the standoff at the Capitol. And yes, I am still right here inside my office at the Capitol.
And you are planning to spend Christmas there, Governor?
For as long as it takes, Ron, we have taken our case to court. We have taken the route of seeking legal remedies. And until we are able to get the legal remedy, I shall stay here.
Of course, today is a holiday and tomorrow, Christmas Day, a holiday also. But do you expect the ruling to come out by Wednesday already?
I cannot speculate, Ron. Mm-hmm. But certainly I can say that during the holidays, you know, the court won't be in session. So in answer to your question, I shall be spending Christmas here. In fact, tomorrow, Christmas Day, will be the birthday of my daughter, mm-hmm. Attorney Christina. And our children, all my children, are one in agreement that I should stand up for this cause, no matter what inconvenience, no matter what difficulties we will have to face.
Over the weekend, ma'am, you had visitors, heavyweight political visitors, if I might say. UNA leaders, Vice President Jojo Binay, former President Estrada, and Senate President Enrile. What did you talk about with them, ma'am?
Yes, yesterday, the Vice President, Vice President Binay, Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile, and former President Erap Estrada came here on a Sunday. They took time out of their busy schedules to show their solid support for my decision not to step down. And their presence here spoke volumes about how UNA regards their membership, that they are ready to support any member that has been the victim of a travesty of justice. Mm-hmm. We have talked about this particular case, and they fully support my stand.
And of course, it has been, your position right now has been described as very similar to what happened to Vice President Jejomar Binay before, when he was trying to be suspended by the Aquino administration when he was still the mayor of Makati City.
Yes, it seemed like a deja vu, in fact. Nancy Binay Alcantara came along also in that visit yesterday, and she commented that it seems like I've been here before. She actually meant the situation. That was the time when her father, then Mayor of Makati, Jejomar Binay, was handed down a suspension order again from the DILG, and he went to the Court of Appeals to seek for a temporary restraining order and injunctive relief. And while they were waiting for the issuance of such injunctive relief, he stood pat on the ground that he would not step down, because it is, and this was also echoed, or in fact brought out by Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile, an order is a presumptive order. If you go to a court of law, that court may then rule on whether or not the order should be carried out. So once the courts have taken cognizance of the case, then it is incumbent upon the DILG not to preempt the decision of the court. That is why I am again calling on the DILG not to insist on their suspension order, because we have gone to the Court of Appeals. This has long been established. There is, and I'd like to point out, this was brought out by Vice President Binay yesterday, a case, and ironically, it involved the father of the president, Benigno Aquino, versus military tribunal. It was established that once a tribunal or a court, in my particular case, takes cognizance of a case, then that any order should be held in abeyance.
Okay, ma'am. We would like to get your reaction also to the closure of Sugbo TV and Sugbo News. We were able to talk to Acting Governor Magpali. She says that this has nothing to do with your political impasse there in Cebu, but she is already ordering the review of the operations of Sugbo TV and Sugbo News, which was started in during your administration. What was the objective of Sugbo TV and Sugbo News? For a lot of us, this may be the first time that we've heard of Sugbo TV and Sugbo News. Can you tell us more about it?
Well, Sugbo TV and Sugbo News reported to the general public largely what mainstream media, for lack of space and time, would fail to report, because as we very well understand, there's so much other news competing for the mainstream media's attention and focus. So that we would report on the beauty, we would showcase in Sugbo TV as well as Sugbo News, we would showcase the beauty of our towns, so that they can also be promoted in the tourism program that I have launched. Mm-hmm. We would report on the culture and the heritage of Cebu and the Cebuanos, and the news that happens here at the Cebu provincial government is also studiously reported. So both Sugbo TV and Sugbo News gave the public a much wider perspective and understanding, as well as information about what the provincial government was doing for them. And not only that, it also gave them an opportunity to be proud to be Cebuanos, to be proud of their culture, to be proud of ourselves as a people.
Okay, and Ms. Magpale did say that this is just going to be a temporary shutdown for a review of the operations and the manpower. Your reaction to that, ma'am?
Well, first of all, let me just say, if she did earlier state that she was just reviewing the operations, she could very well have done that, review the operations without shutting down Sugbo TV and padlocking the studios as well as the offices of Sugbo News. And furthermore, she could very well have reviewed the operations without destroying the satellite dish and tampering with the computers, and practically acting like martial law had set in and they were clamping down on media. You know, a review of operations is commendable, because then she might perhaps start to understand what the operations are all about. If she had absolutely no idea how a TV station or a cable channel works, or how print media works, then this might be that would have been very enlightening and educational for her. But she did not have to act like the Gestapo.
Okay.
And clamp down and shut down Sugbo TV and Sugbo News.
Okay. Thank you very much for that reaction, ma'am. Just going back to your Christmas stay at the Capitol, is it just going to be you with your family there? Are you going to be accepting visitors and guests during Christmas?
Well, there's been a steady stream of visitors, actually, since these past days, and particularly now. They're coming from far-off towns, and they're coming. These are barangay health workers, barangay captains. These are ordinary people coming here, bringing, you know, simple gifts, like they brought their suman and mangoes and some baked cookies and all of these. You know, I just hope that these visitors and these supporters will be allowed entry further on into the evening. As you very well know, there are very, very strict rules about entry into this Capitol compound, which I also do not understand, because this is a public place. Mm. They are made to sign a logbook and surrender their IDs and have their pictures taken. You know, I am overwhelmed with this this show of support by people from all walks of life. And I am just thankful that even though we may have to spend Christmas here, there are many, 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 many others that are one with me.
Governor GWEN GARCIA, thank you very much, and however unusual it may be, Merry Christmas to you, ma'am.
Thank you very much, Ron, and a Merry Christmas to you and your family.
Thank you. And that's your news now. Visit our website, ancnews.tv. Follow ANC Alerts on Twitter and YouTube. And be a fan of ANC 24/7 on Facebook. We'll be back with more news at 3. Keep it here on ANC.